AskFallRadio.com, the flashback show with the homie E, goddamn it. And we got this nigga Rick. Rick, we got Freeway Rick on the motherfucking line. The real motherfucking Freeway from the West Coast, nigga. The nigga that live by the motherfucking freeway, nigga. What's up, my people? Say what's up to the peoples, Rick.
Oh, man, it's all good. How y'all doing?
Man, just chilling, homie. You out like... How long you been out?
I've been out the halfway house about 5 months now.
Damn, that's gravy. Fucking train. My nigga, when I first seen that shit, I was like, oh, my God, they got my motherfucker, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they thought they had me, but you know what I'm saying? We switched that thing up on them.
Real quick, like...
Yeah, for sure.
Now, the first thing I know, the first thing I'm going to ask you is, because some people still don't know, how did you get the name Freeway?
Man, that's a long story, but it's real simple, man. We grew up, my mom's house was on the side of the freeway, and, you know, the name just stuck, Rick Say, by the freeway. And, you know, once I started selling drugs, it took on many lives of its own. But that's basically how it started. But, the police put another twist on it.
Yeah, extra shit like they did my ass back in the day, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Hey, man, you know what I always wanted to ask you? Because, you know, niggas didn't even know. Niggas used to hear about you all the time. And I seen you back in the 80s, you know, once in a while, because I used to fuck with Poo Poo, yo nigga. That's how I got some of your shit back in the day. Matter of fact, where that nigga at?
Poo Poo locked up, man. Poo Poo got 170 years, man.
For that USC student shit?
Yep, absolutely. God, you know exactly what it was.
Yep, I had thought he got it. God damn, I didn't know that nigga got that much.
Yeah.
But what I wanted to ask you is, man, because this was, I don't know, it was a rumor back in the day that you was managing Keith Sweat, like the first part of his career. Did you ever manage?
No, nah, that's a rumor.
I figured that. I'm like, damn, that nigga managed Keith Sweat. I'm like, I don't know, man. Hey, but look, man, you know, nigga, all the motels on motherfucking Fig, nigga, I remember back in the day, nigga, I was like 16, nigga had a front back pancake, seesaw, lowrider, you know what I'm saying? Nigga used to go over there on Fig off of motherfucking Florence, going to Louis Vuitton, you can have a Louis Vuitton room. This nigga Rick had it cracking back in the day.
Now, you know, that was real.
Man, some real motherfucking hood shit, because, you know what I'm saying, you made it to where a nigga done had to go, you know, the Hollywood, Beverly Hills with that expensive bullshit. Nigga, we had our own shit right there in the hood. That's what made the good thing.
Well, you know, that's always been the goal, man, for us to have our own.
You know what I'm saying? Nope. Right there in the hood. We ain't got to go far or nothing.
Absolutely. Man. We got to get our own, man. If you don't own your own, then you're in trouble.
Man, I fucked plenty of bitches in your motels back in the day, my nigga. On the real. Yeah, my nigga. So, shit. Let's get into what you doing lately. What you got a label? What's going on with you?
Well, you know, my main project right now is the movie. I'm working on my life story, the autobiography of Rick Ross.
Yeah.
Also, my social network is flourishing. I think I need like two more people on there to be at 4,000. And you know, I'm putting together the label. I got quite a few artists that I'm working with. We're trying to set up a tour. Ooh, man, that's just to name a couple, man. I got so much stuff going on that I don't even know, you know, where to start. I would need the list.
I seen some a bootleg kind of type movie, like when you was in locked up, the 100 Keys or some shit.
You know, my boys put that together, man. I showed them how to do it and everything, and they went the short end and, you know, and cut me out once they got started and you know, took all the money and ran with it and barely got it in.
Damn,
I helped them put that together.
Damn, okay. Okay, what's happening, K-Mac? I got my boy K-Mac right here.
Is that right?
Yeah.
What's up, K-Mac?
Yeah, what's up, Rick? How you doing, man?
Hey, I'm
man,
good.
You know, I got that $1 million question for you, man, and I know the listeners out there want to know, man. You know, we know that you the real Rick Ross, and then we know that there's this other cat out there named Rick Ross.
There ain't but one Rick Ross.
We just wanted to ask you how you feel
about... His name William Roberts.
Oh, okay. Well, okay.
That's right.
So we wanted to ask you how you feel about, dude, using your name that you know, your name is what has all the stories to it and all the fame, and this cat
I had to give him his props because he was sharp enough to get a name that was hot.
Okay. So do you have any animosity towards that cat, or are you cool with how this thing is rolling?
Huh?
I said, do you have any animosity towards this dude, or are you cool with him using your name?
Well, no, I don't have no animosity toward anybody.
Okay. So that's what's up, man. I just wanted to holler at you about that. You know, I know this is the real Freeway Ricky Ross, not the CEO, right?
Yeah, for real. No, but we cool though. Me and him, we ain't got no beef.
Okay, so that's what's up, man.
We straight.
We heard rumors that he actually
had to next album go triple platinum.
Absolutely, absolutely. So you said you had some social networking happening. So you know, kind of give the listeners an idea where they can follow you at. Is you got a Facebook? You got a Twitter? What is that?
Yeah, I'm on Facebook, I'm on Twitter, I'm on MySpace.
Okay.
But my main one is freewayenterprise.com.
Okay, Freeway Enterprise. Okay. Well, man, we're going.
Yeah, you know, matter of fact, they have some type of contest on there with somebody can hang out with me for the 16th. Mike Epps and him having a comedy show down at the Nakia, and somebody can come and hang out with me all day and just kick it.
Okay. Well, we're going to check that out, man. We know you're busy, man. We want to thank you for coming through and giving us the interview. And, man, we're going to support everything you do. So you got some new music, them artists, man. Get them to us, man. We're going to represent. We'll put you in rotation, and we'll make it happen, man. So stay up.
All right, cool.
Yeah, okay, Rick, one more thing, man. I got this thing I do called Flash News real quick. The nigga Shine, you know, he was incarcerated because of the little shit that he got into at the club with Puffy. Yeah, back in the day. You know, he got deported and all that shit. But the nigga inked a 7-figure deal with Def Jam, outbidding Dr. Dre and Jimmy Iovine. They try to get it, you know, he got an album coming out. He already had this shit ready, I think. So they kind of outbidded him, Def Jam, and Def Jam finna put his album out, man. I guess they're going to get him back to come to the, you know, States or whatever. They're going to get him a pass or something. I don't know how that shit going to work, but they're going to make it happen some kind of way.
Yeah. Well, you know they got all the power.
Yeah, for sure. Well, shit, I appreciate this shit, Rick. I wanted to tell you, Angie called you because, you know, that's my nigga from John Muir.
Okay.
Your, man, me and your sister been going to you know, to John Muir together and shit. Back, you know, she used to fuck with my baby mama back in the, well, she wasn't my baby mama back then, but you know, my baby mama Cynthia, they used to kick it and shit back in the day.
All right.
And I want to appreciate it, homie. Much love.
All right.
Stay up, my nigga, because I was right there with my nigga King T and Ken, resting in peace, when you had that shit over there off of Adams and Crenshaw. You was
finna, man, we finna do it way bigger than that.
Damn,
Freeway Enterprise
got to.
finna be bigger than my space.
Man, you got to, my nigga. And I'm glad I'm part of this West Coast, because I'm gonna be a part of all this shit.
I appreciate y'all support.
Hell yeah, for sure. Okay.
All right, peace.
So stay
peace
up, my nigga. Okay.